KLCS spotlights the winners of the 27th Annual Video in the Classroom Awards in the Los Angeles Unified School District. This is the Video in the Classroom Showcase.
Hello and welcome to the Video in the Classroom Showcase. I'm Jorge Briceño, Director of Educational Television here at KLCS. Throughout the course of the series, we're going to see how students and teachers in the Los Angeles Unified School District combine various disciplines of the school curriculum into award-winning classroom productions. All of the videos featured in our program were recognized at the 2014 Video in the Classroom Awards. Our next feature demonstrates the GoPro camera used by surfers and other sports enthusiasts. It was developed by Nick Woodman, the CEO of GoPro. To learn more about this billionaire success story, let's hit the beach.
This short clip was shot on the GoPro camera. Nick Woodman's creation allowed us to place the camera in dangerous positions. This afforded us to capture video that we would not normally be able to get.
Before we get into the water, let's see how to clean the lens. There are many different ways. The easiest for me is doing it like this. Kai's personal favorite is doing this. He thinks it's more efficient.
She's a sensation, the reason for aviation. And fellas, you got to watch it. When she wind up, she bottom, she go like a rocket. Jump in the line, rock your body in time. Okay, I believe you. Jump in the line, rock your body in time. Heist those skirts a little higher. Jump in the line.
An ordinary day at the beach turns into an extraordinary day at the beach with Nick Woodman's invention, the GoPro. Nick Woodman used his wits to impact the world of technology by creating this revolutionary camera.
As an avid surfer, Nick and his friends always tried to get video of themselves surfing. In order to get decent video, they needed another person with a camera, and that person needed skill with the camera. Nick Woodman was born in 1975. He earned a degree in visual arts from the University of California, San Diego. He founded an online gaming site that failed. At 26 years old, he decided to travel around the world surfing. Nick and his future wife took a vacation to Bali, where they bought shell necklaces for $1.90 and sold them for $60 each. With that money and $35,000 he borrowed from his mother, he created the camera we know as the GoPro. Nick Woodman became a billionaire because he was able to satisfy the need to be able to watch yourself performing action sports.
This is the GoPro camera created by Nick Woodman. It has many abilities and attachments. My partner Kai is going to explain in greater detail. Kai?
Thank you, Riley. This is the GoPro camera. It is small, light, durable, and can fit in the palm of your hand. This particular camera features video, photography, fast motion, and slow motion. It comes with an LCD video screen. This LCD monitor allows you to access playback. It allows you to pause, fast forward, slow motion, The GoPro can be attached to the skateboard, facing away from the skater or towards the skater. The same can be said for a surfer. It can be pointing towards the waves, and it can be pointing towards the surfer. We believe this is the world's most versatile camera. Riley has a plastic case for the GoPro. Riley, would you care to tell us about it?
Sure. This clear plastic housing provides protection for the camera. Now it can withstand extreme weather conditions and even go underwater. This device can be attached to versatile mounts.
Riley, would you care to show us how this camera can be attached to yourself?
Sure. Hold it right there. So, you could attach this to your helmet, where you're skateboarding or biking, or you could attach it to your head on this head strap. It enables a biker or a normal person to be able to take first-person footage. You could attach it here, or you could attach it here.
People all over the world use this camera to document themselves so other people can relive that moment. They also use this camera for action sports, photography, and video.
As you can see, in the top right corner, there's a helicopter drone recording us playing basketball.
We may use it to record action sports, but this ocean biologist is using it to discover marine life. Many different people have their own unique way of expressing how they use their GoPro. In this video, they attached their GoPro to a weather balloon and had it reach the edge of space.
The GoPro now advertises by using other videos that any other GoPro customer has filmed. This is unique since they don't make their own commercials, but they turn any old video into a commercial. Their advertising has really helped the company excel. Now the company has reached billions in profits. Sales almost double each year, plus the company increases in popularity each year. This camera raised the bar for action, sports, and enabled the selfie-obsessed generation to document themselves and share what they do with the world. Nick Woodman uses Wits to create the world's most versatile camera, which has significantly impacted the world of action sports, video, science, and social media.
And now let's meet the teacher whose students produced Nick Woodman using his Wits, Greg LaPittus.
Mr. LaPittus, welcome, and again, congratulations on your Vic Awards.
Thank you for having us.
Let me ask you about Nick Woodman using his Wits. How did this project come about?
That one is for our Unit 3 Treasures Unit, which is using your Wits. And again, it was talking about people in history or currently in current events that have used their Wits to make a difference or to improve the lives of others. One of the two particular boys is a competitive skateboarder as well as a surfer. And somehow they gravitated and found Nick Woodman as being an inspirational person that they wanted to do. And they actually owned their own GoPro camera.
So this kind of leads into my next question. Right. What additional direction or instructions on the research did you have to give them? They'd identified the person they were interested
right.
in.
The process I learned from the Gifted Symposium many years ago was that first they come up with a focus question. What do they want to learn in more depth about the topic they choose? From there, it's simply giving them a couple weeks to compile as many facts as they possibly can. Then they have to summarize the most important facts and weed out some of the more trivial ones. Then it's putting it into an informative yet entertaining format. So we talked about using still pictures, using live footage, using interviews. The whole Nick Woodman GoPro camera, knew nothing about it. That one just blew me away, actually. And so that, again, is the joy and the aspect of working with kids that are capable of having a creative mind, that they're bringing in things that are beyond what I'm asking. So it's really, my hat's off to the kids who did that.
Well, thank you for joining
You're
us,
welcome.
And once again, congratulations
thank
to you,
you
and your students. If you'd like to learn more about the Video in the Classroom competition, go to our website, klcs.org, and click on the Education tab. And be sure to follow us on Twitter @TheVicAwards. Until next time, that's a wrap.